House Senior Living. Our residents feel right at home. Our vibrant facility offers delightful activities and outings. Around the clock,
I am made by men.
And exquisite house-made meals.
Chocolate chip ice cream. Hello, vinyl community. Dave the Pickup Artist with you for another round of Psychedelic Sunday. I've got some new pickups this week and I wanted to show them. Maybe a month ago, I picked up the third album from Fever Tree called Creation. An okay album. The good news is I recently found a copy of their first album, and more superior album in my opinion, and a lot of people think that's this is their best album. Yeah, 1968, and they had a hit off this. It was San Francisco Girls. Their only hit. They never didn't have any other hits after this, although they put out, I think, at least three or four albums. Maybe the third one was their last one. I don't know, but yeah, this has got great guitar work. Yeah, these guys were actually from Houston, and they eventually ended up in San Francisco, and you know, wrote about the San Francisco Girls. And it's on the Uni label. Yeah, that's what I was looking for. I'm gonna check out their second album, see if it's any good. And they've also got a live album out, I found out about, and it's not bad. I don't know about the sound quality, but there is a live album out there too from Fever Tree, but. They call it quits after, the last album, and they didn't, I guess one guy tried to reform the band in the 80s or whatever, but it didn't go anywhere. But yeah, it's a great album. It's a classic psych album. And I got this little, I don't know what that is. They always slip these in the packages. I got that on eBay for $5, actually. It sounds good. I like it. I was at the Wolfson Records the other day, and I went through their dollar bin. I found one album that I picked up in the dollar bin. The first, Chambers Brothers, Greatest Hits. Dollar bin. This sounds great too. It's I played it and there's not a skip on it. And it's got the, what is it, the, it's got the 11-minute version of the, Time Has Come Today. Glad, because a lot of the greatest hits packages on some of the longer songs, they put out the single version of it. So yeah, this is really all you need of the Chambers Brothers, although I am looking to pick up the album Time Has Come Today, because that's a great one. But yeah, this is a great funk site, maybe. Yeah, and we've got, there's a lot of covers on here. People Get Ready, I Can't Turn You Loose, In the Midnight Hour. Yeah, a great band. Another comp I found, it wasn't in the $2 bin, but I found it in the other bins. Quicksilver Messenger Service Anthology. I'm on time! This is a anthology back cover, and we've got the few hits they had, plus a lot of their cool jam songs, which I favor over the hits. We've got Dino's song. That's one I didn't really care for. Mona is probably one of my favorite Quicksilver songs, and it is on here. It's also on, I think, The Last Days of the Fillmore. It was on there, too. They played that. Now, they had one big hit in the 60s called Fresh Air. Remember hearing it all the time, and they do that on here. It's an environmental type song, and it's a second environmental song they have on this album. The other is called What About Me. Yeah, this is very cool stuff. And at one point they had, who was it? I don't know, but yeah, this is a great comp, a great pickup for $5. No scratches. But yeah, this is very cool.
We're here and is very happy to see Northern Ireland ejected Assembly reinstated last month. Now Northern Ireland is a fully functioning government again, and I didn't admit to college. Some people in Northern Ireland represent the great peace dividend of the Belfast Good Friday Agreement.
I'm always looking for an excuse to break out my Nancy Sinatra albums. Nancy put out, I think it was 6 or 7 albums in the 60s, and I have about 5 of them. The first one I have is Sugar. Now, a lot of her albums were genre-specific. For example, this particular album is Nancy doing standards. We have Vagabond Shoes, Let's Fall in Love. She's got a full orchestra, but what's really cool is she's got the cream of the crop as far as the Wrecking Crew. We've got Glenn Campbell, James Burton, Bobby Gibbons on guitar. We've got Hal Blaine, Carol Kay on bass. I'll give you a close-up on that, but yeah, this is a great album if you like standards. The hit off this was Sugar Town. She had a hit called Sugar Town on Papa Frank's Reprise label. The next one I have is Moving with Nancy, or Moving with Nancy. This is basically a soundtrack to her TV special that came out in 67, I believe. This is loaded with great tracks. I love the first track, I Gotta Get Out of This Town. But we've got appearances by several members of the Rat Pack, and we've got Lee Hazelwood and on at least 2 tracks on here. If you've seen the special, and you can watch it on YouTube, it's very good. She does a great duet with Dean Martin, and she introduces her father, who comes out and does Younger Than Springtime on it. It's a great, great special. You can find it on YouTube. And this is a great album. All these are great albums. They're not really psych, but they've got a great 60s vibe to them. To get on Reprise. The next one I have is basically kind of a rock album that she put out. And it's probably her most popular. We've got Boots. Of course, this has got the Boots, the Lee Hazelwood pen song that Nancy's biggest hit, without a doubt. Great cover and bad cover. And speaking of covers, we got a lot of them on here. We've got Day Tripper, great version of Day Tripper. I love it. In My Room, As Tears Go By. The album opens with As Tears Go By, the Stones song. Yeah, this is just a great one. If you don't have this, you need to get it. This is the best. I don't know if it's the best album, but it's the most popular. The next one I have is another genre-specific album. We've got Nancy Sinatra, Country My Way. And yes, it is country. One thing about these albums, a lot of times the same song will appear on different albums. For instance, we've got, the song Jackson is on here. It's also on the Nancy and Lee album. But yeah, that's what they did in the 60s. The Beatles did it. But yeah, this is great country. And we've got a little sticker here. Includes a hit, Jackson, which I think is a better version than the Carter Family version, but I don't know. But yeah, Lee Hazelwood was basically her writing partner and singing partner, and I saw an interview with Nancy, and she claimed that Hazelwood never wore pants. He was like a nudist. If you went to his house, he opened his door, and it was like, oh. But, yeah, he was like Peter Tork. Peter Tork was the same way. He never wore clothes. But She said that she was okay with working with him without pants, but she said that a lot of people were put off by it. But, you know, Hazelwood died about 15 years ago, I think. But yeah, this is another, this is our country album. And finally, we've been listening to Nancy and Lee. This is a classic. This is another must have. We've got covers on here. Starts off with You've Lost That Love and Feeling. I did not like the cover, that one. They started the album off with that, but it picks up from there, and we go into great tracks. Summer Wine is on here, another great track. That's a, most of these are written by Lee Hazelwood. Sundown, Sundown, Jackson, the track Some Velvet Morning, which is what we're listening to right now, is very cool. This is also covered by Vanilla Fudge on their first album, I believe. But yeah, and there's one wanker track on here, great wanker track, called Greenwich, not Greenwich, Greenwich Village Folk Song Salesman. That was very funny stuff. Yeah, they basically poked fun at the Greenwich Village hipsters on it. But yeah, this is just good stuff. Nancy Sinatra. I need about, there's two other albums that I need from her from the 60s. But she actually put out a couple albums later too in the 90s and 2000s. And she had a acting career, very acting. And she was in movies and TV shows. But yeah, and that's all I got this week. I hope you all have a great week, and I'll see you again next Sunday.
He's everywhere, and at this Boys and Girls Club. By the way, I've been a gigantic supporter of Boys and Girls, just the biggest in the country. But when I was a senator, I provided a lot of money during the crime sprees for going on for Boys and Girls Club.
Sky News All-Star Rita Panhey mocked the president for his less than convincing display of strength while out on the campaign trail, saying that he should be living out his golden years in a retirement village.
But first, let's check in on the leader of the free world. Look at that confident gait. He is as fit as a fiddle in body and mind. 4 more years, no problems there. America's enemies must be terrified of this man's strength and mental faculties. You just know China, Russia, Iran are watching on, quivering in fear.